So Colombia is not only a beautiful destination place, but it also has a thriving economy with a lot of investment opportunities that can potentially lead you to citizenship. Let's check it out. Hi there, it's Irena here from Nomad Capitalist. I've been working as the part of the operations team on helping people like yourself to move where they're treated best. So let's firstly discuss why Colombia may be a place for you. I know I'm always mentioning this, but living in a country that doesn't have a sea access, I'm always super attracted to those countries that actually are vacation spots as well, right? You have a vacation every day. What's wrong with that, right? So apart from the beautiful landscapes and apart from everything that Colombia, from the nature point of view, has to offer as well, let's not forget the cuisine in Colombia. Let's not forget the people in Colombia. It's a bit of a different mindset, yes, but the different mindset comes in every country where you go to. If you go to Kuala Lumpur, there will be a different mindset. So obviously that depends. But Colombia, a lot of people are going there because they're looking for a way to diversify their assets, to make investments there because of the thriving economy and so on. So Colombians currently have a lot of expat communities as well for people like yourself who are looking for whether it's a plan B option, whether it's the relocation or anything like that. Colombia 2 years ago had a pretty much better investment scheme than the one that we're going to talk about today. Well, they make it less desirable just because the waiting time for citizenship is a bit longer than it was initially. So where we are today? Today, you can get your Colombian residency by getting a migrant visa. How long does it take to get a migrant visa? It really depends on where you invest. If you invest in real estate, you can get it as fast as in 1 month after you purchase the real estate and you prepare the documents and so on. It depends on the investment route that you choose, but it's usually 2 to 3 months maybe after you made the investment to get the final approval. How you can get that and where you can invest. Number one option is real estate option. And again, if you're watching our channel, you know that real estate investments, depending on where, but are one of our favorite ones. And if this is the first time watching, well, take a note of that. So when it comes to real estate in Colombia, you would need to purchase a real estate that is worth 350 times average salary in Colombia. So overall, in 2024, that amount goes to approximately $116,000. Pretty cheap, right? And you can also rent out that property and receive a passive income that way. So again, pretty cheap. Another option how you can get a migrant visa is to invest in a business. So this option is cheaper. So you have to invest only approximately $33,000 or so into the business. Again, it's cheap, but if you invest into real estate, you purchase a property, rent it out, you receive an income. If you incorporate a company, for example, or invest in the corporation, there are additional costs that come after that. So that's why we usually do not recommend it. There is also an option for you to invest in a corporation by buying shares. And that investment is approximately $216,000. And this is the only way that you get qualified for a 5-year visa. The rest you have to renew. So let's talk about the documents needed. When it comes to documents needed, there is not a lot that you need. You really need the usual documents like passport copy, ID card, bank statements, proof of funds, health insurance, and so on. As you may need some additional things, like for example, your CV or letter of request or something like that to basically prove that you can invest into business and not just some random person who decided to invest. When it comes to the process, it sounds simple. It's a bit more complicated than that, but the process basically starts by collecting the documents, of course. When you have the documents collected, then you need to open a brokerage account in Colombia. When you open the brokerage account, which can take a couple of weeks, then you fund that account with the investment price. You make an investment and you complete, for example, the purchase agreement. Let's say that was real estate. You complete the purchase agreement. After you've done that, you can apply for a visa online and get the stamp in your passport. After that, all you need to do is to go to Colombia and apply for cédula, which is kind of an ID in Colombia. Now, let's discuss on the path for citizenship. As I mentioned earlier, Colombia had a better deal when it comes to a citizenship path. Currently, migrant visas that you apply for are valid for 3 years. So then you have to renew it. Only the last investment option that I mentioned into buying your shares is qualified for a 5-year. This you have to renew. So migrant visa is basically valid for 5 years, all in all. After the period of 5 years, then you can apply for permanent residency. In order to keep your migrant visa active, you need to visit Colombia once every 6 months. So basically, you have to go to Colombia twice per year and for 5 years. After that, you apply for permanent residency. But what you got to make sure is that there is no lap between the migrant visa and the permanent residency. You need to apply for permanent residency before your migrant visa expires. When you get your permanent residency, if your goal is citizenship, you got to make sure as well that you visit Colombia once per year at least. The physical presence is not really determined. Earlier, it was said that you have to visit Colombia once every 2 years. However, with some of the new changes, they decided to really put it once per year, but the days are not clarified. But the more time you spend, the better, because your goal is citizenship. So if you can spend 5 months per year in Colombia, that would be great. You know why? Because that wouldn't qualify you for tax residency as well. So you wouldn't have to pay taxes to Colombia. Basically, to go back, I will discuss that a bit later. I will mention that a bit later. But to go back, if you visited Colombia once every year and like that for 5 years, you can get your citizenship. There are some tests like language tests, history tests, and so on to perform when you want to apply for your Colombian citizenship. So all in all, it would take 10 years to get it. One thing you need to be careful about that I mentioned is that if you spend more than 6 months in Colombia, you may be considered a tax resident in Colombia, and tax rates in Colombia are not the greatest ones out there. So make sure to keep an eye on that. So that's how you get a migrant visa. If you are ready to start your Colombian adventure with us, get in touch and we'll be able to help you out. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.